So I don't know, I think a lot of you already heard about Swift AI, and I'd like to give you some updates. So it's continuously being developed. And yeah, so just as a reminder, Swift AI is a personal assistant. It's completely free and open source. So we believe like the conversational web, where people actually talk to applications, so it's going to grow. And what we see right now is that Google, Alexa, IBM Watson, and Microsoft with Siri, also of course Apple with Siri, yes, so they are like dominating the market, and these solutions are not free and open source. So we need a solution, and there are a few approaches like Microsoft and others out there, and so we are doing Swift AI, where actually we focus on the server itself. Okay, so it could be used also in a business. It's always important that there is an income model, so for example like B2C, B2B, and it can be installed in-house. So that will also be the big difference to Google, where you send all the data to the US. So we have APIs, we have a wiki-style author link, and that's how it looks like. So we have an app here on the App Store, which you can test if you like it, and the idea is to have it run on every device. So every device means yeah, something like that. We have different clients then on the web, on Linux, Android, iOS. We also like experimenting with Magic Mirror, this mirror that you can like you can look into the mirror and then you can see different things. But, yeah, I'll get the link there. And they want to open that.
So basically, so we develop an extension because we see in different Vortex. So we have is on the Magic Mirror, also on Draw. If you there is a SUSE extension, you can download and SUSE directly on your browser. So I can see it also.
Okay, so let's look at it. Okay, so yeah, who knows the Magic Mirror? Who does know the Magic Mirror? Have you heard about it? No one actually knows the Magic Mirror. Exactly. Everyone knows the Magic Mirror. Okay. So what's the Magic Mirror?
So it is an open source and hardware project. So they view the mirror and that recognize your face, and you can program it. I think in the background is the Raspberry you want. And then you can basically interact with your mirror. You can communicate with your mirror. So when you come and then people say, okay, hello, Mario. And then they can recognize you. They use like face recognition to tell you your height, your name. And then also basically like it's Snow White. The story, yeah, and this if you Google the report story on GitHub, everything available you can install. They also have the guide how you can build a mirror. So if you're interested, you can find it out. And what we did, our community, what we did is we try to build an extension for this project so that they can pull SUSE from the mirror.
So you see something. So what we actually focus on is the screen. So there's the screen behind the black glass, and it looks like something comes up from the mirror. So you want to talk to it, you want people to use SUSE AI. Mm-hmm. So that's yeah, it's pretty okay. So okay. And
it's possible to build yourself a pump?
Yeah, it's possible. Okay. Yeah, so they have the guide, but of course it's desktop. So the Magic Mirror you can build it is the instruction, and if you want to install extension, the extension is there. You can also install.
So these so and then you can set up the messenger bots. How we want to make it very easy for people to contribute. So there, of course, like people can contribute to the code, but people can also create skills. So we have a page here which is skills.suseai, and on this page you can. Then, like, access the skills, and you can edit them on the fly, just like in Wikipedia. So, for example, I click here on the skill. I'm not logged in right now, but like, I can already see a lot of data which I cannot see, like let's say on Alexa or on Google. So we also make more data available, whatever is possible, make it available to people. Then you click on edit the skill, you need to be logged in. But even if you're not logged in, just like on Wikipedia, you can see the code. So you can see here, you can, for example, embed APIs very easily. Yeah. And there's a guide how to write skills. You just click here on the information and then open the tab, and there's a tutorial what you can do with skills. So for example, what is a skill is a description, and then here there are random pandas. So are you all clear what is a skill? So a skill is just like something like an app, but it's a voice conversation. Yeah? So, and so for example, like tutorial level number one is very easy. You ask a question and you can just define random answers. And you define them through, like, what's it called in English, that straight line?
So, pipe.
Yeah, through a pipe. So, you just like make pipe and then, like, there will be a random answer, for example. Or you can, like, turn it around, random questions and then one answer. So just go through this tutorial and you will see the different variables are possible. You can set status variables, you can make conditions for answers, you can define functions and embed JavaScript. So the system is written in Java, but like you can embed it in NASHORN. You can call an external API. So any API that you can think of, of course you can use JSON. So there are more action types that we embed. So for example, like what you see here is the table, pie chart, RSS, web search, map, image, videos. So it's not just that you have a voice client. For example, you can say to a voice client, show me the map on my phone, yeah, things like that. If you have any ideas for more action types, you can let us know. And so what's the future here with the regards to the tutorials? So we are now until tutorial level number 12, and number 13 is problem solving dialogue with counter questions. We already some basics implemented, so for some cases it works already. Problem solving dialogue means you ask a question and then you answer, and then the system asks you a question, for example. You ask a question, so it's, and you say yes or no, right? How does the system say what the yes or no relates to? So this is a dialogue with counter questions. And expert system with backtracking, intent reflection, please read up on it. We don't have too much time to go into detail here, but of course we know what's the future. It's an inter-SUSE instance dialogue, so you can have two SUSEs talk to each other and you can join the conversation, right? So that's pretty clear. Now what you can check out right now is already here the skill creation, and if you log in, you can also build your private skill and embed this skill on your website, for example. So you can have a window like this where you can type in something, you can have your personal, like, you know, like these icons that open on your website, you can have that with SUSE. Then, okay, actually, we're logged in here. So for example, you can check that out here by clicking a bot builder and then, like, following the tutorial here step by step. Just filling in something, and Fonseca, just give me the money, Fonseca. Salut, okay. And then, so there are different options here. For example, you can have, of course, the code view for the developers who want to include a lot of people. So we have a UI view as well. And let's say you can change the background, of your personal board. Or you can also choose an image. After the image, you can have your own icon, or you can choose your own photo somewhere. So, and we're adding more and more options, for example, that you can only allow the bot on your own domain, things like that. And that's pretty much it. Then save and deploy. It will load. The underlying system is a Git system. And so you copy this one, just a script, into your HTML code, and then you have this pop-up. That's pretty much it. Yeah. So straightforward. How people can use it. And we have like the Dunman High School. Anyone from Dunman High School here? Or previous Dunman High School? No. So we had like 100 students in Dunman High School who recently did it in one of our courses. Okay. So create a SUSE bot. And the next thing is create the hardware.
So, we try to also react a speaker like what Amazon and Google have, but we use very simple components. I can show a video to see how it can be done in 1 minute that you can do it. So this is some of them. So look at it.
So this is this video was done by Michael Robinson, who's a core developer, who speaks German, you can read it. I can explain a bit. So what we do is for the speaker itself, we just try to find a really cheap speaker that's available on the market and just disassemble it. Yeah. So the goal is that everyone can build it. Yeah. And then we take a Raspberry Pi. So we have our own Linux distribution that you can find on the GitHub channel. And we use the speaker Pi Head, which is being assembled at the moment. And there are different pre-speaker Pi heads, right? You know, there are the rough ones as well and so on. But the one with two mics has an advantage because it has a button closer. And we use this button for some functionality. Yeah. And then pretty much we don't have a nice casing and so on, because right now the important thing is actually to assemble it and to try it out. And there are a lot of questions. For example, one question is about the sound, right? Like, how do you calibrate it? Yeah, I mean, if you calibrate it too high tolerance, it just switches on all the time. You say something, and maybe it sounds like Susie for the device. Yeah, and so this is always a question: what is a hardware question? What is a software question? To figure actually out quite some challenges, but and you just use the SD card, then use the ISO from our GitHub repository. So we are releasing ISOs already, and at the moment, the question was also to have an automatic ISO build. I don't know if anyone has built a Raspbian image before. Yeah. Okay. Of course. So the challenge is actually to build ARM images on the Intel infrastructure and so on. So we didn't really succeed in that. And we also submitted some bug reports to the Raspbian guys. So what we're doing at the moment, we're building the images on our own small Raspy cloud. Yeah. So you need actually, if you build for hardware, you need to build on hardware. And components we have here, for example, so we have online and offline components. The goal is also to make everything run offline. So we're using Flight here for it, but if we are using it online, we're using Google or Watson or whatever is available to have a good sound quality. Speech to text and this Pocket Sphinx, and again, the Kubernetes, but yeah. So we're running out of time, but you see, maybe Father Krishnan is also very impressed. Right, so that was good. Of course, we incorporate that with the other people in the South Asia community. Kiwi, for example, also have casing and things like that. And we're looking forward to catch up with you.
Yes, so because we have another 1 minute, right? I want to make a quick announcement for the South Asia Summit 2019. So I want to use up all the time. So next year going to be our 10th anniversary. The call for speaker is open, so please check out the website forasia.ng. You will find all the information on the website. Please sign up for talk. One last comment. So all the components to be the Susie speaker can be found at the end of the YouTube video, and maybe check out Chum Picks. They can watch it.
Yeah, watch the
company. Okay, so that's all.
Thank you.